Indian street food is a favorite all around the world for its delicious flavor, and bhel puri is definitely a favorite. Made using puff rice, lots of chutneys and a plethora of spices, it tickles the taste buds like nothing else. So come, let's waste no time and see how to make this Indian favorite. I'll start by adding coriander mint chutney in a bowl. I have the recipe for these chutneys on my blog and I'll leave the link below, so do not forget to check them. Because these chutney makes a lot of difference in the taste of your bhel puri, so make sure you make them according to my recipes as well. Here is some tamarind chutney. The recipe is again on the blog and I'll leave the link below. Next up, add some chopped onion, chopped tomatoes, green chili. Now green chili, you can adjust the amount according to your preference. I do not like too much of heat, so I'm using just 1 teaspoon of green chili. Fresh coriander, boiled and cubed potatoes. Now we'll add salt to taste. Red chili powder, chaat masala, and lemon juice. Now mix all these things very well so that everything comes together and the chutneys and the masalas are mixed up with the onion and tomatoes. If raw mangoes are available, you can also add them. Just finely chop them and add them at this stage. They give a very, very nice taste to the bhel puri. But because they were not available yet in the market, so I am not adding them. Now everything has come together very well. Now last, maybe we will add a puff rice to it. Give it a very quick mix so that all the masala is coated on the puff rice. Now you can adjust the amount of chutneys according to your taste. If you feel that they are too less or too more, you can either decrease the amount or increase the amount. But this quantity is what I feel perfect, so I have mentioned it. But feel free to adjust it according to your taste buds. The bhel puri is ready. Now finally we'll garnish it with some nylon sieve. And these sieves are the very, very fine sieve that you generally sprinkle over the chaat. Sprinkle it over the bhel puri. Give a very, very quick mix and the bhel puri is ready to serve. You can either serve it in a bowl or the traditional vendor style, you can make small cones using newspaper, or actually not newspaper because there's a lot of ink in that, but you can use any other paper, plain paper to serve this bhel puri. Here you go. Bhel puri is ready to serve. Serve it really quickly after you mix it up. Did you see how easy it was to make bhel puri at home? So now you don't have to step out. You can make your favorite sitting at your home and in a much hygienic and in a much tastier way. So if you like this recipe, do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make sure to click on the bell icon to get all the notifications whenever I post a new video. If you have any question or any query, leave me a comment below and I'll definitely try to revert back on it. I will see you all very, very soon with a new recipe. Till then, bye-bye.